Hello, I received this parcel from the Hong Kong Now store. For some reason, these parcels always arrive pretty battered, but usually the contents are fine. It contains three puzzles that can be purchased through the links in my description. First out is a hamburger Rubik's Cube. Then there's a sloppy cube. And lastly a 2x4x6 cuboid. This is called the Yummy Cheese Hamburger 3x3x3 cube and it's part of the Hungry collection. I love the way Chinese attempts to name things in English usually fail dismally. Or maybe they just haven't heard of cheeseburgers. Obviously it's just a regular Rubik's Cube with a printed image. Maybe one day I will attempt to make a puzzle made out of a real cheeseburger. This is a flat 2x4x6. I've never understood why pillowing is used when flat as possible. Even if, like here, it's necessary to make the cubes different sizes. The movement is far from great, but it's still a nice puzzle. So, on to the last puzzle and by far the best. Designed by Oscar van Deventer and mass produced by Calvin's Puzzles. So this is Oscar's sloppy cube. Now luckily it's new because nobody wants sloppy seconds. Oscar says it's incredibly hard to mix up. I think that's because of all these weird kind of like angles of the cuts. So obviously you can make the first move kind of like wherever you want. But after the first move, you can see things aren't lining up as you kind of want. Well, actually that is lining up. So presumably I can move that one. I can't see anything else though that can be moved. Everything is just, I mean, you can kind of like force it, but I'm not going to do that. I think perhaps if I take it further, then I can move, yeah, then I can move that one. Let's see what happens if I do that one 180 degrees. No, that doesn't really do any good. Do it to there. It's not anything even remotely close to being movable now. Okay, so let's go back. Problem is I kind of forget what I've tried. So it's basically really hard to even find a fourth move. Let's try something else. Okay, we've got a move there. Okay. Try 180 degrees. I've just kind of got a sneaky feeling 180 degrees might make it slightly easier, but it hasn't. Nope. Well, I can see a line through there, but I can't move it there, though. That's a problem. I mean, the fact that I can't even scramble it kind of indicates how incredibly difficult it must be to actually solve. So I do assume it's probably like a like sort of bandage cube. It's just that it doesn't sort of look like one. Ah, so we've got another move there. I think that's four moves I've managed to do. Yes, so I've got that as well. So that's, I think, five. Okay, we've got a move there as well. So it's really just trial and error. I'm not even sure if that's a new move or whether I've just gone back. Right, so that's almost mixed up. I'm just wondering now whether I can actually get it back. I mean, it's not properly mixed up, so it's not even going to be a solve if I can get it back. It's just kind of like reversing the moves, kind of through luck, I think. I really want to move through there. Just trying to get these. Well, I'm definitely not going back. I am actually scrambling it more, so that's actually a good thing. It's weird because I took so long to find any sort of moves, and now suddenly they're coming a little bit easier again. Now I'm just thinking about trying to put the yellow into place. No. It's stuck there. Well, let's see if I can get that, put the red into place then. Problem is these, because these aren't in line, it's kind of just, it's making it difficult to put the, to get the red up into the right place. Just sort of randomly messing around with it. No, I'm not getting anywhere. So I haven't really scrambled it and I haven't put it back. I've just kind of like done that. And if you'd like to buy this puzzle, just check out the link in my description.